Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel PMA Project Management Academy. Guys, in this video we will discuss how to create or add a new project in Primavera P6. So guys, this is Mudassar Malik. I am professional trainer of Oracle Primavera P6 and Microsoft Project Professional. So in this video we will discuss how to add a new project in Primavera P6. So an unlimited projects can be created under any EPS node. Maximum character length for any project ID is 20 and for project name are 100. So whenever you want to create a new project file, you require these information before starting new project file. So first of all, you need project type like commercial buildings. We have commercial buildings. So next, project title and project ID, company name, project start date, project finish date, responsible manager, planning unit, work days per week, I mean calendar settings, decimal places, currency settings, and week starts on. So these information you have required before starting a new project file. So I have just arranged a sample information. Just project type is commercial building, building project, and project title is construction of passenger terminal building, and project ID is PTB. PTB stand for passenger terminal building. Okay. So company name is Descon Engineering, and project start date is 1st Jan 2023. And project finish date is 31st December 2023. So this is 1 year project. So responsible manager is a project manager, Mr. X, Y, Z. Mr. Ali. So planning unit day. We will plan our project in days. Okay. So we have other option also. Project you can plan in weeks, in hours. So in days, so I select just here, we will plan our project activities in days. So work days per week should be 6 days in a week. Okay, so 6 working days in a week. So next, decimal places is 2, and so a week will start on Monday. So let's jump to the Primavera P6 file and learn how to create a new project file in Primavera P6. So let me open it. So now software is opened. So go to file, then click on new. And first of all, we will select EPS, select the enterprise project structure level for the new project. So click on search button, and from here you will choose which kind of project you are going to plan. Like we are going to plan a commercial building project. So double click on it. Before starting project file, you have required to create a EPS, your EPS. So for EPS, you can see my other videos how to create EPS. So I will share your link in description. You can see that how to create EPS. Okay, so then click on next. So here you need to enter project name. Enter the project ID and project name. The project ID is a short unique identifier for your project. So let me add here like PTB, passenger terminal building. So project name is, let's jump to the Word file, and here is construction of passenger terminal building. Copy from here, Control C and Control V, paste it here in project name. Then click on next. So next is project start date. So project must start from let me check from Word file. So project start date is 1st Jan 2023. So click on search button and go to next month, 1st Jan 2023, and must finish by, and it should be 31st December 2023. So you can select from here. December 31st, 2023. Then click on next. Next is responsible manager. Identify the responsible manager. The responsible manager you select will be at the top of the organization breakdown structure OBS for the project. So click on search button, and here you can see your responsible are here. So these are OBS, basically organizational breakdown structure. So if you want to learn how to create OBS in Primavera P6, so you can see my other video. I will also drop their link in description. You can check from there. So double click on project manager, Mr. Slim. So always responsible manager is project manager. So double click on it. Then click on next. So rate type should be price per unit. Okay, then click on next. Congratulations, your new project has been created. To modify your project properties and define properties not covered by this wizard, click on the enterprise menu and then click projects. Okay, so click on finish. So now your file is created. So let me show you how to open project file. Go to file, click on file, then click on open. And now you can see here is in commercial building, your project file is showing here. So you can double click on it, or you can select and click on open. In both way you can open your project file, but it is not showing in a Gantt chart window. So how to show a project file in Gantt chart window? Go to view, next group and sort, and in group by field select WBS. Click on blue cell, drop down list will appear, and press W key from keyboard, then click on WBS. Okay, then click on OK. So now you can see your project name is showing here. Construction of passenger terminal building. So guys, I want to show you a little introduction of this interface. So this top row, like Primavera P6 Professional 20 PET construction of passenger terminal building. This is title bar basically, and this is main menu bar. Okay, and this is standard toolbar. This is left vertical standard toolbar, and this is right vertical standard toolbar. And this left window is called activity table window. You can see it is break from here. So this left window is called activity table window, and this right window is called bar chart window. So this whole window is called Gantt chart. So this is the way how you can create a new project file. So please subscribe my channel for upcoming videos notification. Thank you very much.